Hey friends, Jackie here from Interact. Let's talk about the cover photo that you should be using on your quiz. Because let's be honest, even though you're not supposed to be judging a book by its cover, a lot of people out there do. So if people are looking at your quiz, you want the image to be really captivating, engaging, and make them want to click start so they can take your quiz and subscribe to your email list. Let's look at Josh Hanem, our CEO's top tips for choosing your quiz cover photo. Tip number one is that the person in the photo should exemplify the dream state or the ideal state of where your quiz taker wants to be, right? So what I mean by that is imagine somebody frustrated looking for a certain answer to a problem that your quiz is going to address. It's going to sort of evaluate where they're at and then tell them exactly what they need to do next. So what does that next step look like? How will this person feel? What will they be doing? What will they be achieving once they get to that level of success with your quiz? Maybe this is an image that conveys a certain mood or attitude. Maybe it's something that's aspirational, making someone feel encouraged to want to take this next step. Whatever that is, you want your quiz taker to see themselves in this quiz, and you can really showcase that by choosing the right cover photo, something that looks like them doing the thing that they need to do to get to this ideal state that your quiz will help them get to. One more thing on this tip is to remember where the person is going to be when they take these next steps or these calls to actions that you're going to give them. If it's something that they'll do at home, make sure you're using a picture of somebody who's at their house. If it's something that happens at work or in an office space, then use a cover photo that shows someone working in an office. Let's look at this example. What's your ideal diet plan? So you can see here the woman in the photo is creating some healthy food. She's happy and she's in the setting of her own home. Someone looking for their ideal diet plan might be in these same comfortable clothes, relaxing at home while upgrading their diet. Versus this quiz, which type of professional photos do you need to reach your entrepreneurial goals, should showcase someone who's a professional. So someone who is dressed up, ready to go for work. Looking excited about the success that they're going to achieve on this journey. This could actually be the professional photo that somebody might get if they were to get this specific result in the quiz. So you can see the difference between the two quiz types and how the images really speak to those different quizzes. Okay, tip number two, e-commerce quizzes can use a cover photo of people or of products. So what is the quiz about? Maybe it's, you know, which type of mountain bike do you want? Then showcase the different mountain bikes that they might be able to get at the end of this quiz. Non-e-commerce quizzes should usually feature a person or people. I say usually because, right, there's no end-all rule for this. You can absolutely use a cover photo that doesn't have a person. But if you don't, if you are not showcasing a product within your quiz, it's a non-e-commerce quiz, then typically the best cover photos will be with people. Again, living in that I dream state, accomplishing what it is that your quiz takers, your ideal customers will be doing as well. And here's that exact mountain bike example, somebody who's actually riding a bike that someone could get at the end of this quiz, which mountain bike is best for you. And tip number three, the number of people in the photo should reflect the number of people that the quiz addresses. So, for example, we saw earlier which diet plan is correct for you. That's one person. So, we only want to showcase you in that photo. You're the only person involved in that quiz. But in a quiz like this, what does your relationship need to reignite the spark? A relationship has two people. So, we show both of those people here in this cover photo. In Interact, your cover photo must be landscape orientation. To add a photo, you simply click on the image placeholder, and you can either search for an image here using our directory with Unsplash or include a GIF, or you can upload your own photo. Just note the recommended dimensions that are right here. I would recommend resizing the photo before you upload it. You just click Choose File, select your image from your files, and click Upload. And we even offer these little grid lines to help you with that one-third rule, right? So you can make your cover images a little bit more aesthetically pleasing by using this one-third rule, keeping the subject of the image in one-third of the screen. So you can see here, my bike rider is over to the left, leaving this space open. Once you're ready, click Crop and Save, and your cover photo appears in your quiz. The last tip I want to leave you with is don't be afraid to test out the image that you're using on your quiz cover. Publish your quiz, share it around, give it some time, and then look at your quiz analytics. Are the number of people who are viewing your quiz clicking in to actually start it? If not, or you're wanting to increase that conversion metric, then try a different quiz photo. With Interact, you can make any change on your quiz, whether that be to the cover photo or something else, and then simply click publish and then publish changes. When you do this, wherever your quiz is already shared live, on your website, on your social media, the whatever changes you've republished will automatically be updated wherever your quiz is already shared. You don't have to change out the link, you don't have to re-embed anything, and this allows you to test out different images to see which converts best so you can ultimately grow your email list. There they are, our top tips for choosing your quiz cover photo from our CEO, Josh Hanum, who's made thousands of quizzes over the years. Hopefully now you have a good idea of which cover photo you want to use for your quiz, whether you're uploading your own or searching from within your Interact account. If you're still not sure or need any help finishing up your quiz, head over to ai.tryinteract.com and have a quiz built for you. We'll select a cover photo and add it to your quiz sent right to your Interact dashboard, and that cover photo will follow all of these best practices.